continue the discussions within our conference on the differences that we have, that we're continuing to try to litigate. Consequently, we will not be on the bill this week, but we're still working toward getting at least 50 people in a comfortable place.
Well, that was Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell publicly announcing that he is delaying the vote on the GOP health bill. That was, of course, put together in private. Maybe if you didn't put it in private, you might have more Republicans who would actually vote for it. Of course, they've been under intense pressure from many of their constituents as a result of this particular bill. Of course, Democrats are lined up against it. McConnell wanted the vote taken before the July 4th recess, but that will now take place afterwards. Now, of course, after that took place, President Trump convened a meeting of all 52 Senate Republicans at the White House to try and find a way the bill could be tweaked to guarantee its passage.
We're going to see what we can do. We're getting very close. But for the country, we have to have health care. And it can't be Obamacare, which is melting down. The other side is saying all sorts of things before they even knew what the bill was. This will be great if we get it done. And if we don't get it done, it's just going to be something that we're not going to like. And that's okay. And I understand that very well.
Okay, so the other side was saying things before they knew what was in it. Well, that's what happens when you actually do it in private. But here's the reality. Once the bill became public, folks quickly realized that it was an atrocious bill. Not only that, the AARP, you have, of course, the American Medical Association, March of Dimes, American Diabetes Association, American Cancer Society. Numerous organizations have come out saying, do not pass this bill. The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops even against this particular bill. Republicans know they're under intense pressure when it comes to this. They've been getting thousands of phone calls, and now many of them are going home for the July 4th recess. And look, some Republicans have been having town halls, been getting lit up by their constituents when it comes to this bill. I'm going to show you a video a little bit later of one guy who tore into a Republican member of the House who voted for the House version of the bill. Let's talk about this bill, and let's hear from what do doctors think. The National Medical Association, of course, is a body of black doctors and physicians. Dr. Doris Brown is the president-elect of the NMA. She joins us right now. NMA, I would assume that you're joining the legions of others who say bad bill for the American people.
Absolutely. We are on board and have signed on that we are opposed to the bills, both the American Health Care Act from the House as well as the Better Care Resolution, a Reconciliation Act from the Senate. The National Medical Association believes that health care and health is a right, not a privilege. And we are opposed to things that do not increase health care access, affordability, and high quality health care.
And when you look at this bill, when you see the CBL report showing more than 20 million Americans are not going to be able to get health care, when you look at the exorbitant cost that seniors are going to have to pay, I just don't know in what world. Granted, we already know he has no logic whatsoever, but I don't know in what world Trump even saying this is a great bill.
Yes, this cannot really be a great bill for any Americans, and most especially for the minorities in this country. The low and middle income individuals, the uninsured, we know that with the Patient Protection Care Act that has become law, we have increased the number of uninsured. Certainly, there are now 26 million individuals that didn't have insurance that now have it. And if we go with what is currently being touted in both the House and the Senate, this would reverse that. And the National Medical Association stands ready to oppose that because it impacts the patients that we serve to the greatest extent.
Now, of course, both, as you said, the House has already voted.
Yes.
Speaker Paul Ryan also spoke out yesterday with regards to what took place after the Republicans announced their decision to pull the bill. Here's what Ryan had to say.
Look, I would not bet against Mitch McConnell. He is very, very good at getting things done through the Senate, even with this razor-thin majority. I have every expectation that the Senate, I don't know what day, but I have every expectation the Senate will move this bill, and I assume this bill will have changes.
What is stunning to me is that this is the Senate really just trying to pass something, because logic does not dictate how you can have a bill that impacts 1/6 of the U.S. economy. Republican senators didn't even know what was in it. They found out late. You're trying to rush it through. The president is lying when he says that Democrats are obstructing. There was no effort even made to involve Democrats. No amendments even offered to even make any changes to it. And it is just stunning to me that it will come down to this and it'll be done in secret.
Absolutely, and it's astounding to the members of the National Medical Association as well. We take care of these millions of poor, underserved individuals that have been afforded the opportunity to have health care that they did not have. They did not have to worry about not being insured with pre-existing conditions. Some of the rights for women, the preventive services that are now afforded under both Medicare and Medicaid. And we understand that there's a rising age in the population of America. The bill that was in the Senate again is going to add an age tax, which means that we will then end up with increasing costs as we get older in America. That is not the American way.
Well, and when you look at the states that Trump won, they're going to be most impacted by this bill as well. And I think when these senators go home, if any of them, wherever they go, if they're seen in public, I would not be surprised if they get an earful from folks when it comes to this particular bill.
Absolutely. And we are certainly encouraging our membership to really speak with their senators to write letters, because this is going to impact their health care in the future, and it is going to be devastating to the states, the reversal of the Medicaid, the putting a per capita tax, again, devastating for the constituents that we serve.
Dr. Doris Brown, President-elect, National Medical Association, we surely appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.
All right, folks, our panel today, Greg Carr, Chairman of the Department of Afro-American Studies at Howard University, Sue Zodak, Founder and CEO of the Zodak Agency, Spencer Overton, President of the Joint Center for Political and Economic Studies. Sue, I'll start with you. Again, as a Republican, it has to be embarrassing to Mitch McConnell to put this bill forward, and all of a sudden it's no after no after no. Not only were there five no's before he made the decision, then after he made the announcement, several more came out and said they were no's as well.
I don't think it's embarrassing. I think that miscategorizes the smarts that Mitch McConnell has in terms of negotiating this thing. But first of all, you know, to the CBO score, out of the 22 million, 15 million, according to the CBO, these are not my words, will voluntarily give up their health insurance because the product that's on the market does not fit their needs. Okay, it's not 50 million people being, you know, the healthcare is being wrestled away from them. The CBO says 15 million people will voluntarily drop out because they don't like the product.
But remember, the CBO also said in that exact same analysis that people will be paying lower premiums, but will be getting less health care.
That's what people want.
No, the CBO is saying that the Republican bill will provide less health care than the current Affordable Care Act.
It'll provide less health insurance. Okay, there's a big difference between providing insurance. What Obamacare does is subsidizes an insurance product. It doesn't subsidize health care.
Will the Republican bill cause individuals who are 50 or older be paying premiums sky high? Will it cause...
It's going to go up by maybe 10-20%.
Are you serious? You literally had a member of Congress, United States Senator Susan Collins, say that seniors in her state will see more than a 200% increase in a medium average family earning $56,000. 40% of all their income will go to health care under the Republican bill. You call that slight?
No, I don't. Yeah, I think Collins is choosing and nitpicking her statistics very carefully.
No.
What are you talking about?
out.
But Roland, it's very clear. This wealth transfer thing may come apart. I mean, we've heard from Dr. Brown, and congratulations, the National Medical Association has been on the front line from the beginning. These are our people. What we see now, it's at the moment of crisis. Mitch McConnell has about $188 million, a billion rather, between the Senate version and the House version to play with, try to buy off some of these senators. Lisa Murkowski in Alaska has already said, along with Senator Collins, you can't buy us off for that. In Ohio, Rob Portman listed in John Kasich, and some of these bipartisan governors who come out and said, that's a spit in the ocean for opioids. At the end of the day, they are on the verge perhaps of collapse, but I think McConnell's plan, you're absolutely right, he's being shrewd, and he's working with Ryan. They're going to try.
Course.
They're going to try to fix this bill, to negotiate with that $188 billion. They're going to fail. And then it's going to mess, and then it's going to come apart.
When you have the AARP, the March of Dimes, who McConnell refuses to meet with, even though they saved his life when he had polio as a kid. When you have the American Cancer Society, the American Diabetes Association, the American Medical Association. Right. When you have numerous groups that are not insurance companies, that are not hospitals saying this is bad for American people, that should cause Republicans to say, we got a problem.
We need to hold on for a minute here. And the impact on black folks is significant. If you look at Medicaid, right, so of that 22 million, about 15 million cut over the next 10 years is from Medicaid cuts. About a quarter of black folk use Medicaid as their insurance here.
Expand this thing, Sue. 50% of all individuals who are in nursing homes, most of those costs are paid by Medicaid. Mm-hmm. Are you actually trying to tell me that the Republican bill is helping American people?
Well, let's talk about Medicare cost paying for.
No, answer my question.
I am answering your question. There's a big problem with that, and it absolutely should decrease. All we have to do is take out the union skim that the SEIU has taken out of Medicare, and we'll cover way more people.
Let me say it again. 50% of all Americans who are in nursing homes, Medicaid is covering those costs. Again, answer my question. Will this Republican bill make their health care better?
This bill reduces the coverage for Medicare for people making 400% of the poverty line to 350% of the poverty line.
What this bill does is helps the people who are making $400 and $500 million.
Right.
This bill helps those individuals. This bill does not help those poor folks in Kentucky, in Arkansas, in Mississippi, in Alabama, in Maine, in Vermont, in Iowa. It does not help at all. And you're actually saying it does?
No, I'm saying that we shouldn't. Those states that expanded Medicare made a huge mistake, and they shouldn't have given out that Medicare to begin with.
It's about transfer.
Wow.
That's it. Simple. Absolutely. Simply put, this is a tax bill that they're trying to disguise as health care.
Weekdays on TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh, my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't want to talk to us. He wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no.
No.
That ain't gonna cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin, weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.